Hello guys, and welcome to one more video on my channel again. So this is going to be my favorites of January. I think it's a little bit, tiny bit late to do this video, but not too late to show you the things that I liked from the month of January. So stay tuned to see the rest of the video and see what I liked on that month. First thing first, I'm going to talk about my three foundations that I really liking it. I'm really liking to mix them and do things with them. So this is the three foundations that I'm liking. The first one is the Dior Skin Star Studio Makeup Spectacular Brighten Weightless Perfection. It's a long name. Foundation. This one, it comes with 30 of SPF, and my color is 020. I don't know the name of the color, but yeah, it comes obviously with the pump, and I really like this foundation. It's a more luminous foundation, but it's not too shiny and too oily and too hydrating for oily skin types like me. It's really good if it's perfect for that people that likes a full coverage foundation. These have a lot of coverage, and people that like people with oily skin that loves luminous, dewy skin look without that oily looking stuff on the skin and too shiny and too strong for them. This is the perfect foundation for you guys. This lasts every day. This is full coverage. This covers everything and looks perfect and hairbrushed and really beautiful. And I really recommend this foundation for you guys. And the next foundation that I'm going to show you, it is the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Plus. This is the mattifying foundation, oil-free and water-resistant. So yeah, I really like this foundation. The color, it is 30. The name, I think, is on the website of Sephora. It comes with the squeeze tub. I really like this foundation, more than the Dior one, because this one makes my helly. It's more full coverage. It's more mattifying, and it really controls the oils coming from these areas of my nose. Even when I powder it, use powder on it, it comes through when I use the Dior one. It's really good, and on my forehead too. It just doesn't make my skin. It lasts all day long, and it controls any shine and everything. And the other foundation that I use to mix, this is more a mixed foundation. I use just only one time alone. This is the Bourjois 123 Perfect Foundation. This is the correcting foundation. It comes with three corrective stuff. It's anti-redness, anti-dull, and anti-dark circles. Anti-dull complexion, everything. And I really like this foundation because it doesn't make my skin crack on these lines. And I mix this foundation with the Dior one and with the Makeup Forever one, and it's perfect. Really like mix with this foundation with these two foundation, that is the foundations, that is the Dior and the Makeup Forever one. So really recommend these foundations and really like them. And this foundation also have a kind of very good coverage. It's more medium, but you can build it to full coverage. But it's a little bit more harder to build, but builds as beautifully as the other ones build. So I really recommend these three foundations, and these ones, it's been on my favorites of this month. Really like this. Next, it is my favorite concealer of the time. It is the Chanel Perfection Concealer, or Concealer Perfection. In the number is 10, and I think the name is Beige Claire Claire Beige, Claire Beige, whatever. What else? I really like this foundation. It's not the lightest that I wanted to do this really highlighted under eye, but it covers so much my dark circles and looks so perfect and beautiful and doesn't crack like, you know, like others. And it's beautiful. I really, really like this concealer. I really recommend it. So yeah, this is the Chanel Perfection concealer, whatever. I really like this. Next, it's another product from Chanel also. It is the Poudre Universelle Libre Natural Finish Loose Powder. And I really like this powder. It comes with a lot of powder. This is going to last me a lot of time. I still have so much powder and I use this quite a lot. And I really like this powder. It makes your skin really hairbrushed, soft, smooth, velvet. And also I bought this stuff because Olivia Eldridge used this a lot on her videos, and Nikki Tutorials also used in a few videos of her on more antique videos. And I really, really, really like this powder. It's beautiful, it's expensive, but it means everything, you know, every little single thing of money that I spent on this, it's just good. It's a good thing that I bought, you know, it's a good thing that I really like it and really like it. I don't know how to explain. I really like this powder. Next, it is the MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus Broom, whatever it is. I really like this stuff. I bought this today, but I used it on my skin. It makes my skin really smooth, really. It just makes my skin hydrated and plump, and took away the looking of powder on the skin. I really, really, really like this, and I really recommend. Many people use this, so of course it's a good thing to spend money. And it's not that expensive like many other stuff from MAC have. But I really like this stuff, and I really, really recommend you to use it. You can use it for make more pigment your eyeshadows. You know, when you're going to put eyeshadows, you can spritz on your brush and make your eyeshadow 10 times pigmented. You can use this as a finishing, fixing, whatever it is, I forgot the name, finishing spray. You can use this as a primer before you put your foundation, and before your foundation, and after your foundation, whatever you want. I really, really like this stuff. I had to put this brow pencil by Kiko Makeup Milano on my favorites of January, because I really like this. And this is the Kiko Makeup Milano Precision Highbrow Pencil. The color is brunette, and this is the dark color for dark hair like mine. And I like this stuff. I love this stuff because it is really good. I can really draw my brows really well, and I'm really happy with it. I don't have nothing more to say about it, so yeah, I really like it. Also from Kiko Makeup Milano, I bought the Luxurious Lashes Waterproof Mascara. And I really like this stuff because this is really, really waterproof. And I love waterproof eye mascaras because every time I put mascara without being waterproof, they smudge everything down here. Even this one sometimes smudge, but nothing compares to the normal one. So yeah, I really like this one. You have to wait this stuff to dry a little bit because it's quite watery when you start to use it. But when it comes to more, when it starts being more dry, it's just beautiful. It just makes your lash really big and beautiful, and I really like them. So yeah, I really recommend it. Next, I used this a lot on the from January, and I'm going to still use it as long as I can. This is the Kiko Makeup Milano False Eyelashes in natural, something called natural lashes or natural something. The number of it is 01, and I'm using them right now. They are not too extreme and not too short or too natural, but they are brilliant. I use them every day. I don't feel them really. I just love them. As you can see, it's really beautiful. I really like them and I really recommend it. Next by Kiko Milano 2, I bought and I use this a lot. This is the Kiko Makeup Milano Glow Blush and Highlighter. This is 2-in-1, you know. It comes with a blush and highlighter. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Make your cheeks really highlighted, really glossy, like the way I love. Like you can see here, when I put my skin on the light, you see this glow? I love this stuff. This makes my skin really glowy, dewy, fresh looking. I love this stuff. This is the sad part. This is limited edition. So, yeah, but I really like this one. I think it's going to last me a good amount of time. So, yeah, I really recommend it. Kiko Makeup Milano 2, as you can see, I really like this. That store, it's cheap and have awesome stuff. These two single eyeshadows by Kiko Makeup Milano. One is a more purple color, and I really like this stuff because they are really pigmented. This is the color, it is 223. As you can see here, the color. And then another one, it is the Kiko Makeup Milano 2. The number, it is 213, and this is one of my favorites of these three. Another, it was black, but not the blackest, so I didn't put all my favorites. But this one is my favorite. It is dark green, shimmery, beautiful, and I'm wearing underneath on my lash line. It's beautiful. It's beautiful, I love it, love it, love it. So yeah, I really recommend these shadows. They are really pigmented, worth the money. And they are not pricey, they are cheap. Considerably, whatever that word I said, cheap. And I really like them, and I really recommend them. A old favorite, it is, I think this is the last thing, yeah, is the last thing that I'm going to show you. It is the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion. This stuff, oh guys, you're not going to believe, but I use this every day. And this stuff, it lasts me like 1, 2, 3 years or 2 years. And it still have stuff here to use it. I think this worth so much the money you can't imagine. You just have to use this a little bit on one side and another to really, and this stuff really, it just make my eyeshadow, oh my god, I don't know how to say it this, because I really like this stuff, because it doesn't make my eyeshadows crease anymore. Because before I was trying to put the eyeshadows and everything, when I didn't use this, it creases because I have oily highlights, and this stuff really, really locks everything that I put on highlights. Boy, it just locks eyeshadows, highlighters, pencils, whatever I put it on. It's just brilliant and it's just beautiful. And I really like this one. And this lasts years of using it. I don't have to buy another one. It's a little bit expensive, but it's worth the money so much. It can last you a lot, and still good, and still really good to use it, and I still use it, and I'm going to use it forever until it's really finished. So yeah guys, this is the finished product, my Urban Decay Primer Potion. Guys, this is the end of my video. This is the second video today. It's because you can see that I'm wearing the same clothes and the same makeup and same hair and everything from my last video. That was my haul. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I did these two videos today for really update my channel, to really pump off and put some videos on my channel, to really update my channel. And yeah, Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. And don't forget to see all the links down below, like Facebook, Instagram, and everything. Don't forget to follow me on that social media stuff, like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, AskVM, Tumblr, everything. Every link and everything is down below. And also my blog. It's everything down below. So don't forget to check it out. And I think I'm going to put every name of these products, of my favorites, down below too, if I don't forget it. So yeah, I think it's everything. See you soon on my next video. Hopefully it's going to be a makeup tutorial or get ready with me or something like that that I usually do on my channel. So yeah, bye bye guys, and see you soon on my next video. Don't forget to thumbs up this video and subscribe on my channel to see more videos of me here on this channel. So thank you again, and don't forget to see me on my next video. So see you soon on my next video. Bye bye.